Welcome student in our today's online section of subject mechatronics. Today we are going to see our chapter number 6, which is PLC. In short, we called it as a programmable logic controller. Here you can see it is a PLC and name of the chapter is programmable logic controller. In this chapter we are going to see about the logic controllers, its constructions, architecture of PLC, then selection of PLC, ladder logic programming for different type of logic gates, latching, timers, counters, PLC controls of hydraulics and pneumatic system, then mechatronic system involving time and counting operation. So all this is we are going to study in this section, which is programmable logic controller. Okay, so here we are going to see its introduction. So in a programmable logic controller is a digital computer used for automation of electromechanical processes in modern factory automation. The term electromechanical processes means where the combination of mechanical devices and electronics devices is present. That's why we name it as a electromechanical devices. Example of this PLC controller users are control of machinery on factory assembly line, as well as heating, ventilation, air conditioning, then plastic injection molding machine and commercial washing machines. At all these places we are going to use the PLC, which is programmable logic controller. Okay, a programmable logic controller are unit specific industry devices for interfacing to and dominant analog and digital devices. They are designed with small instruction set appropriate for industrial control application. They are sometimes programmed with ladder logic that could be a graphical methodology of laying out the connectivity and logic between system input and outputs. PLCs are designed with industrial management and industrial environment specially in mind. Therefore, additionally to being versatile and simple to program, they are sturdy and comparatively resistant to external interference. Programmable logic control is a microprocessor based control unit designed for an industrial system in a power switchboard to control equipment or an industrial process. It consists of a CPU with memories associated on input output interface housed either in a compact box or in modules obstructed in a frame and connected with proprietary buses. A PLC works by continually scanning a program like computer code that's understood by an embedded microprocessor, which is CPU there. Okay. Here you can see a PLC are members of computer family using integrated circuit instead of electromechanical devices to implement control function. In short, a programmable logic controller is a specific processor used to manage machine and processes. They are capable of strong instructions such as sequencing, timing, counting, then arithmetic, data manipulation and communication to control industrial machines and processes. Here you can see a process or machine, and it is integrated with the programmable logic controller. And then why we are going to use this PLC? It is a hardwire panels, relay logics are very time consuming to implement due to wiring and debugging related issues. Is in need of another controller which is a faster, operates in a real time, then withstands vibration, temperature, humidity, noises, then has inbuilt interfacing for inputs and outputs. It is flexible and adaptable. It is easy to program or reprogram, easy to troubleshoot and maintain. It consumes less space require less wiring and comparatively cheaper. So that's why we prefer PLC, or these are the need of PLC. Again, discussing about its advantages are such that it is a high flexible. A single PLC controls several machines at a time. Its cost is low. Prices of PLC vary from few hundred to few thousand. This is nothing compared to the price of contact and coils and timers that you would pay to match the same thing. Then it corrects errors. In recent days, with wired relay type panels, any program alternation requires time for rewiring of panel and devices. With PLC control, any change in circuit design or sequence is as simple as retyping the logic. Correcting errors in PLC is extremely short and cost effective. Then it is a space efficient. PLC memory is getting higher and higher. This means that we can generate additional and more contact coils, timers, sequences, counters and so on. We can have a large number of contact timers and counters in a single PLC. Then it is suitable for testing, visual observation. It is reliable and it is having a communication capability. Then it is easier to repair, or it is easier to troubleshoot. PLC have diagnostics and override the function that allows user to easily find and correct software and hardware problem. Discussing about this disadvantage, high work required in connecting of wires. For programming and wire connections, always need a skillful worker. If problem occurs in PLC wiring and programming, then hold up time is large. PLCs is only good for yes no decisions, not good for continuous type signal. Ladder logic style is bulky and prone to mistake due to similarities in symbol. Here various symbols is we need to use. I will teach you the symbols as we proceed in the chapter. Then selection criteria for PLC, here are some. How you are going to select the PLC? So the PLC is programmable logic controller, can be select on the basis of application requirement, then its input and output requirement, memory requirement, then CPU requirement, software requirement and operator interface, communication requirement and environmental requirement. So on this basis of this, we need to select the PLC. Then input output devices in terms of the for the PLC. So input devices provides input to the control system. In case of a discrete state process control, the inputs are two state specifications such as limit switches, comparators and push button. So here we are again having some more input devices. The processors and input output devices are pre-packed along with the input output terminals are available but cannot be changed. The most advantage of this type of packaging is low price. Modular input output is split by compartment and into that separate modules can be plugged. An analog input card converts a voltage or current, example signal that can be anywhere from 0 to 20 mega ampere, into a digitally equivalent number that can be understood by the CPU. A digital output card either turns a device on or off, such as light, LED, small motors and relays. These features greatly increase your choice and also you can select from the module available from the manufacturer and blend them in any means you want. The output devices accepts the output from the control system in discrete state process control. The output accepts only two state commands such as light, motor and solenoid. The lights are either on off, motors which are rotating or non-rotating, the solenoid which are engaging or not engaging. Solenoid, it is mainly you know this in H&P also, where the solenoids are used to on and off the walls there. Okay, so here are the some input output devices here. So here you can see these are the input devices and these are the output devices. The output devices are motor, whether it is running or not. Then output devices type is solenoid, whether it is engaged or not engaged. Then light, it is specially red. So light which is glowing or not. These are the outputs of this PLC and these are the input devices in the PLC. It is a momentary action such as push button, then it is a physical limit button, then it is a pressure limit where pressure is applied to the here, then it is a temperature limit. Here what is happening, because of the temperature rise the filament increases and there is a connection established. Then lever limit, these levers are need to be pushed. So these are the input devices in PLC and these are the output devices in PLC. This relay sequence I will teach you in the next section. Then it is the architecture of PLC. So this is the architecture of this PLC, programmable logic controller. Here you can see it is having a input module channels, CH1, CH2, CH3, these are the input module, and the CH4, CH5, CH6, these are the output module, and between them we are having the processor or PLC. A programmable controller can be studied by considering the basic elements shown in the figure, which is the processor, input modules and the software. Okay. The central processing unit CPU is the intellectual of the PLC. It's the central processing unit. The components can be listed: input, output model, CPU, the memory, then power supply which is required to run the PLC, then programming devices and communicating channels. And communicating channels. So here it consists of a microprocessor for implementing the logic and controlling the communication amongst the modules. It is designed to so the desired circuit can be entered in a relay ladder logic form. The processor accepts the input data from the various sensing devices, executes and stores the user program, and sends appropriate output commands to the control devices. Okay. Now this input output sensing device, then output load devices, I already teach you. We will see the next concept in the next section. Today it is I am ending here. Thank you.